Hello students, we will be understanding the concept of assignment operator in this particular video. So by understanding the concept of assignment operator, we will be performing a program that shows that how two integers value can be swapped using just the assignment operator. So before moving to that, we will be taking a simple example to understand that how this basically assignment of operator works. So for that, we will be taking one simple day-to-day life example, an easier example to make the understanding of swapping the values of two integer variable very easy. So for that, what we will be doing, we will be taking two beakers A and B instead of two variables. The A contains the red ball and the B contains the yellow ball. Our aim is to swap the balls. That means what we want as the output at the end, that the A should contain the yellow ball and the B should contain the red ball at the end of this whole problem solution. So for that, what we have done, we have taken these two beakers A and B with red and yellow ball. Now we will be taking one single beaker, empty beaker C, because there is a condition that one beaker can contain only single colored ball at a time. So we will be taking a beaker C, that is an empty beaker, to solve this particular problem. So now here we will be using an assignment operator. This will show that how actually the assignment operator works. So what we are doing, we are placing the red ball from beaker A to beaker C. Okay, so that is beaker C is equal to beaker A. So we have placed a red ball from beaker A to beaker C. So this is exactly how the assignment operator works, that whatever is the value on the right hand side of the assignment operator, here assignment operator is equal to. So whatever is the value on the right hand side of the assignment operator will be given to the left hand side of the assignment operator. So our assignment operator was is equal to, on the right hand side we were having the value red ball in the beaker A. So where as soon as we did beaker C is equal to beaker A, the red ball moved from beaker A to beaker C, that is from right hand side to the left hand side. So now our beaker A is empty. So what we will be doing, now we will be putting the yellow ball from beaker B into beaker A. So for that, what we will be doing, beaker A is equal to beaker B. So on the right hand side is beaker B. So value in the beaker B, that is the yellow ball, will be placed into beaker A. So now our beaker B is empty. So what we will be doing, we will be placing the red ball from beaker C into beaker B. So what will happen, the red ball from the beaker B, that is beaker B is equal to beaker C. So value of beaker C, that was the red ball, is shifted to the left hand side, that is beaker B. And so now at the end, we got our required output, that is A contains the yellow ball and B contains the red ball. So this was a generalized way of understanding how to swap the values from one to another. So now let's take this thing further by using by creating the C program using the integer variables A and B. So for performing the C program, we will be using our Turbo C compiler. So in Turbo C compiler, we will be creating a new file for creating the program. So what is this program we will be mentioning in the comment? That is understanding the concept of assignment operators. We will be understanding the concept of assignment operators. For that, we will be creating a program for swapping the values. The reason of understanding the assignment operator is because whenever you will be performing any type of program, you will have to assign a certain values to the variable so that you can perform your operations. So it is very important to understand that how and in which way the values are assigned. So we'll be starting our program using the header files, that is standard input output.h, and then we'll be including our another header file, that is console input output.h. Then we'll be starting with our main function. The main is the execution point of our program. Any compiler starts compiling the program, its execution from the main function. So there we'll be taking integer a, b and c, in which our values will be stored, over which the operator will perform its operation. Then we'll be using CLR, SCR, that is for the clear screen, so that the previous outputs, whatever they are on the console screen, are clear, and only we can see our required output. Now, we'll assign the values A is equal to 10 and B is equal to 20. Okay, so let's print the values before swapping. So we will be printing the values before swapping first. So they will be printed as A is equal to percentage T and B is equal to percentage D. After doing comma, we will be placing the variables, which will be respectively substituting the percentage T, that is our format specifier, for the integer variables. Now we will be performing our swapping. So it was C is equal to A. If you remember, in the previously I had shown the concept that how it works, the beaker C is equal to beaker A. So the red ball was moved. So similarly, we are doing over here, C is equal to A, then A is equal to B, and B is equals to C. So now we will be printing the values after swapping. Let's see whether our values have shifted or not. So for that, we'll be using our printf statement to print the values after swapping. A is equal to percentage T and B is equal to percentage D. Wherever we are applying slash n, the slash n stands for next line, so that our whatever thing we want to print in the output, that prints in the next line. So that's why we are using slash n, and then we'll be using get ch so that we can get our output. First of all, we'll save our file. So let's save our file as swappingprogram.c. So it is swapping.c. First of all, let's compile it to check whether there are any errors. So there are no errors present. So now we'll be running the program. Okay. So as we can see that before swapping, the values of A was 10 and B was 20. After we had done the swapping, the value of A has become 20 and B has become 10. So this is basically how our assignment operator works, that the values on the right hand side of the assignment operator will be placed on the left hand side of the assignment operator. Thank you.